Hey guys, my name is Suna and welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, make sure to subscribe so you guys are notified when I upload a new video. So today I come to you guys from my tiny little kitchen. So lately with all the news and all the negative energy that's been going on around, I have been feeling a bit anxious, to be honest. I don't want this channel right now to be, you know, only things about the virus and stuff, but I know there are a lot of people out there who might be feeling anxious. So I decided to make this video, which was supposed to be a weekend in my life staying at home, but I decided to change the concept a little bit and turn it into ways I deal with anxiety. So the first thing on my list was to make myself my favorite breakfast. I feel like when you take the time to make yourself something really nice and then you can actually enjoy it, it can help a lot. It can make my mood better, and just the process of cooking and preparing it, I think it's just really nice. And this is a really easy, simple, and healthy recipe. So I'm going to be making banana oat pancakes, which I told you guys is my absolute favorite, and I haven't made it in a very long time. So the first thing we need is rolled oats, whichever kind you usually use. I just got this one from Emart. We're going to need a little bit of milk of your choice. I decided to go with soy milk. We're going to need one egg, one banana, and if you want, we can add some cinnamon, and I'm going to do that because I love cinnamon. So this is my blender bottle. I know it's very small, but everything I own is like single serving, so this is what I'm gonna use. So I'm going to start by putting oats in it. Since I haven't made it in a while, I'm not entirely sure how much I should put in it. And I'm going to put my egg and my banana in it. So this is what it's looking like. I'm going to blend this up. Oh wait, milk. I almost forgot the milk. So let's give this a shake. You know, it's just for like the consistency, because otherwise it's really hard to blend. Maybe if you have a good blender. Mine is not really that like strong or anything. So I'm just going to give this a little shake, because the oats tend to get like stuck in the bottom. But we'll try. So this is what it looks like. So I have my pan here. What I realized is that, I don't know if it's like the bananas or the oats or something, they have like fats, I guess, like natural fats. So it doesn't really stick on the pan. So I'm just going to heat it up, make sure it's nice and warm. I forgot to add the cinnamon. I'm just gonna do that right now and give it a good mix. I mean, stir. Well, I guess I could just add it at the end. I'll just add it at the end. So I just put in the first pancake. This is how it's looking. It's like bubbling. Okay, I need both hands to do this. And this is what it looks like. It looks like an actual pancake, right? It looks so good. And if you guys could just smell this, it smells divine. And I also have some organic agave syrup, which is what I'm going to add to my pancakes later. And I'm just gonna make sure this does not burn. So while the pancakes are cooking, another thing I really enjoy doing is making something nice to drink. So this is the coffee I've been drinking almost every day, I would say. I have this jar. I add a handful of ice, and then I have this cold brew I bought from the grocery store, and I'm just going to pour that in. And I put in my metal straw, and yeah, just give it a stir. And I just love the sound. ASMR, guys. So this is what the pancakes look like. Just look at them, also prettily stacked. Let's add some cinnamon. Sprinkle that. Whoa. I love cinnamon, so I can like overdo it. And then the syrup. Okay, I'm gonna try to not mess it up. Ooh, yes, look at that syrup. Oh, I should have added the cinnamon after. Oh, okay, this is not good, but it's okay, it's okay. It'll still taste good. So this is the final result. Doesn't this look super, super good and tasty? And I have my coffee right here.
So I'm going to take some time to eat these and relax.
So I just finished eating breakfast. It was so, so, so good. I finished up my coffee too, and I'm feeling a little bit better. So another thing that really helps me get over this anxiety is just to keep myself busy while doing things I really enjoy. So lately I've been enjoying just drawing on my iPad. I'm not a good drawer, artist, anything, but you know, I just try to doodle and just do little things, and it doesn't matter if it's not good. The important thing is to try and just keep your mind busy. So I have my iPad here, my Apple Pencil. So I don't know how well you can see my iPad here, but we'll see what I'm gonna do. I have no idea, actually. I've been really enjoying doing this kind of like quotes lately. So for example, this one says, remember to always treat others with kindness and yourself too. Just, you know, like those little self-care quote kind of things. Another thing I really, really like to do when I'm feeling like this is just journal and organize my life. So I use these two notebooks. This pink one over here is a 3-year diary. So basically, I'm just going to show you a clean page because I actually have a lot of clean pages. So it comes with the date on here on the top, and then it has three little spaces. So basically I write here the year I started it, and then just circle the date, and then I can write anything I want in here. So I started it last year, but I didn't write much. For example, in the beginning, I actually did quite good, I think. So all of the first rows are for 2019, and the ones in the middle are for this year, 2020. I really like it because I've tried like actual journaling and bullet journals, and I feel like those things don't really work with me. But this one, since the spaces are actually really small, it's really not that intimidating. So for most days, I just write like a few lines just about what I did in the day or something I want to remember or just how I've been feeling, you know, just write down my thoughts, and I feel like that helps me a lot. And for my other journal, this one I got for free at Starbucks. I guess it wasn't entirely free. That just means I went there a lot. So they had 4 different options, I think, but I went with the light blue one because I just liked the format of it. This one in the beginning has all of the monthly spreads for the whole year. After the monthly spreads, I get the weekly spreads. So it just says the months up here and then just the day. So I have these kind of spaces. And after all of these weekly spreads, I have a ton of these dotted pages. And after that, I have also blank pages. So yeah, that's how I like to journal and organize my days. So it's a bit later now, and I've been sitting here on the floor the whole time, so my butt hurts a little bit, to be honest. I have no idea why I'm still sitting on the floor. But anyway, I wanted to tell you guys some other things I like to do to, you know, combat this anxiety. And I think one of the most effective ones is to exercise. I do have a gym membership in a gym really close to my house, but of course it's not recommended to go to gyms right now, so I haven't been going, even though it's a pretty small gym, so it's not like a lot of people are there. But you know, just to be on the safer side, I haven't been going to the gym for a while now. But I did exercise at home, and I really like doing Blogilates. So you can look up Blogilates on YouTube, and there are tons and tons of workouts there. I really like Cassie's energy and the method she tries to, you know, share with the world. And if you go to her playlist, she always has like daily workouts pre-planned for you guys, so you can always just click on the respective dates playlist, and she's gonna have like 4 or 5 videos there just ready for you. I was feeling really anxious since last night, so in the morning I was still feeling really anxious, and I think it was worse because I didn't get to sleep much, so that also affected a lot how I was feeling and my mood in general. So I kicked myself out of bed, and I just took out my yoga mat, put on some workout clothes, and did exercise at home. And I felt a lot more awake and already a little less anxious. And after that, I took a very long, warm shower. That's also another thing I really like to do because it helps me like relax. I don't have a bath, but if you guys do, you could totally also take a very warm bath and just relax, you know. I think that's very important, especially during these times. And another thing I really enjoy doing is connect with the people I love, be it friends, be it family, and just check on them. And thanks to the internet, nowadays it's so easy to check on other people, you know. You can stalk them on Instagram or just send them a message or just FaceTime them, whatever you want to do. So living alone can get a bit lonely sometimes, and I don't get me wrong, I really do enjoy living alone, but it's during these times that I sometimes wish I had someone with me. And that's one of the reasons I really want to get a pet, because back in Costa Rica I used to have two cats, and the older one is 10 years now. I've had those cats for a very long time, since I was in middle school, high school. So anyway, these are some of the things I like to do when I'm feeling really anxious. Just remember that this will all pass, and if you guys need someone to talk to, know that I'm there for you. We can always use the comment section here, but I'm most active on Instagram, so you guys can follow me there and DM me, and I'll make sure to read all of them, and we can have a conversation there in case you guys need to. Let me know in the comments down below what other things you like to do when you're feeling anxious. So these are just some quick remedies I like to apply to my daily life to feel less anxious, and I hope you guys found it helpful, and I'll talk to you guys really soon on my next video. Bye.